So to answer this, we want to look at these for loops and decide how many times each warp is going to have to execute the for loop. And that means how many times at least one thread in the warp is going to have to execute it. So looking at this expression here, for a single warp, these values will vary from 0 to 31. So there will be at least one thread in that warp for whom this modulo expression evaluates to 31. And that means that the entire warp is going to go through the motions of executing this bar function 31 times. Now, some of those times, some of the threads will be deactivated. So the very first time, thread 0 will not execute the bar function. It'll be deactivated because I will not be less than 0. And the next time, threads 0 and 1 will be deactivated and so forth. Ultimately, the total amount of time that the warp has to spend in this loop depends on the total number of time that any one thread has to spend on it. Each warp will execute this loop 31 times. This next loop, though, is different. In this case, the integer divide means that threads 0 through 31 are going to evaluate to 0. This expression will evaluate to 0. And therefore, they're not going to execute the bar function at all. And then threads 32 through 63 will evaluate this expression to 1, and they'll execute the loop once, and so forth. So there'll be one warp which evaluates at 0 times, one warp which evaluates at 1 time, one that evaluates at 2 times, and so forth, all the way up to a single warp which evaluates at 31 times. So the average number of times that all of the warps will execute this loop is 15.5. So now we know what we need to know to answer the question. Clearly, the second loop will execute faster, and it'll be twice as fast, because on average, the number of times that the expensive bar function gets evaluated is half the number of times that bar function gets evaluated during the first loop.